Welcome to the GMO life-changing talk. I know it changes lives because I give it all the time and I do a pre and post-test show of hands to see what people's eating habits are like at the beginning. And I know at the end they all change. So I know what's going to happen. And by telling you this, then I might be challenging you to try and, you know, get real stubborn and say, I'm not going to change my diet no matter what Jeffrey says. But I think it might change. Yesterday in New York City at the Green Fest, I did a pre and post test show of hands, and it took 10 minutes. 10 minutes where most everyone in the room decided to be more vigilant in avoiding GMOs. How many people here are concerned about eating GMOs? That's easy. Now the hard stuff. Rate yourself from 1 to 100. How vigilant you are in avoiding GMOs. This is the pretest. This is where I want you to assign yourself a number today for how vigilant you've been up to now. And then I'm going to tell you some information, and then I'm going to ask you to rate yourself how vigilant you're going to be after this point. And my guess is that you will be more vigilant. Well, let's do it by categories. Most Canadians, on a scale of 1 to 100, where 1 is low vigilance, not at all, and 100 is high vigilance, most Canadians are about minus 20. Same with America. Knowing that GMOs are in the food supply, not knowing which foods are genetically modified. So you have permission, and you are expected, for most of you, to be in the lowest category of 1 to 20. So raise your hand if you believe you're in the lowest category, 1 to 20. Please raise your hand and keep it up so we can look around and see. 1 to 20, okay. Wow, all right. 20 to 40? 40 to 60? 60 to 80? 8 to 100. So if 8 to 100 was the least populated area, I'd say 20 to 40 was one person more maybe than the 1 to 20, which is rare, and 40 to 60 was similar. So it was pretty even, all right? So that's the pretest. Now, how active are you in getting the word out about you? Most people are not particularly active. That would be 1 to 20. Raise your hand if you're in the 1 to 20 category. 20 to 40? 40 to 60? 60 to 80? 80 to 100. Clearly, the biggest category was 1 to 20, then 20 to 40, and then down to nothing. Any 120s like me? Okay. Anyone not like raising their hand? How many farmers? Any farmers in the audience? Yes, let's hear from the farmers. Any gardeners here? Lots of gardeners. Anyone eat? Most of them, some people. So, I did not bring a PowerPoint. I did not structure the talk in any particular way. I'm just standing here ready to give you whatever comes out spontaneously, because I wanted to do a little interaction. What are some of the health problems you are concerned about with GMOs? Anyone? Yes. Fertility. Is anyone here planning to have children? Still, raise your hand. All right. So fertility is an issue. Now, let's talk about fertility and focus pretty exclusively on that piece. I'm personally convinced that the Roundup Ready crops are particularly dangerous for fertility. Now, there are three or four reasons why it might be. One is that the Roundup itself is in high concentrations of Roundup Ready crops. How many people do not know what Roundup Ready crops are originally? All right. So I'm going to start, before I get to the fertility thing, let's paint the background. Right? There are 9 genetically modified food crops. 9 that are commercialized. And the 5 major ones, soy, corn, cotton, canola, and alfalfa, alfalfa is made in the US and not yet in Canada, their primary function is not to die when sprayed with Roundup herbicide. They're called Roundup Ready. So bacterial genes are inserted into their DNA, and they cells are cloned into a plant, there's massive collateral damage in the plant and all sorts of changes in the nutrients and phytoestrogens that are never accounted for or evaluated. And the reason why GM crops, primary reason, is to sell more herbicides to the farmers and to make it easier for them to weed. The cotton and corn varieties can also be BT cotton or BT corn, BT, Bacillus thuringiensis. It's a soil bacterium and it is a natural insecticide. It breaks open the stomach of insects, it kills them, it's put into the DNA, a gene that produces that is put into the DNA of corn and cotton so the plants can kill them. Now, let's, any other general questions about GMOs? Because I'm moving fairly quickly to get to this health data.
The problem that it causes for thinking.
All right, so
because
thinking. So we're going to start at fertility and then go to thinking. Yes? We'll get the hands actually in a minute. I'll answer these questions first and then I'll go back to the hands. Because we've got three to deal with. It's going to take a bit of time just to get through those. Because fertility itself is pretty intense. So, the evidence, just the pure evidence, rather than the reasons why. When mice were fed genetically modified Roundup Ready soybeans, there were changes in their testicle cells, including damage to the young sperm cells. When rats were fed GM soy, the testicles changed from pink to blue. Female rats, there were changes in the uterus and ovaries. The embryo offspring of mice, DNA functioned differently when the parents were fed GM soy compared to non-GM soy. Female rats were fed genetically modified soy starting 2 weeks before they got pregnant. More than half of their babies died within 3 weeks, compared to 10% death rate, which was the offspring fed non-GM soy. The babies were also smaller and could not reproduce. Hamsters fed GM soy three generations over 2 years, by the third generation, most lost the ability to have babies. They died, the infant mortality rate was 4 to 5 times greater, they grew slower, some had hair growing in their mouths. Mice fed genetically modified Roundup Ready / BT corn had fewer babies and smaller babies. In India, buffalo fed cotton seed cake. When it was non-GMO, had no problem. When it was GMO, most had reproductive disorders. Prolonged periods of infertility, prolapsed uterus, miscarriages. There was also skin problems, milk production problems. An article came out last week about a Dutch farmer that took pigs off of GM soy and put them on non-GM soy. The litter size went up from 28 per pig month period to 30. The ability of the pigs to get pregnant increased dramatically. They also had reduction or elimination of the diarrhea problems and lots of, maybe 2/3 reduction in expenses. These are astounding results. And we don't know exactly the cause. I talked to the scientist with the hamsters by email. He's from Russia. They haven't published a study about the hamsters yet because they haven't, they're trying to isolate whether it's the Roundup or the genetic engineering that's causing the problem. But there's another problem that might also be involved. Dr. Don Huber, a plant pathologist, professor emeritus at Purdue University, is one of the leading experts in Roundup. And he became aware of some scientists, veterinarians, and others who discovered a new organism. It's an organism that's new to science. It may not be new to nature. It's only visible in an electron microscope. So it's tiny, but it's the size of a virus, but it's not a virus. It looks more like a fungus. And when farmers and ranchers complain of huge amounts of animals not getting pregnant or losing their fetuses in miscarriages, invariably there's high concentrations of this organism on the aborted fetal tissue. It's also found in semen in bulls that are not getting their cows pregnant. It's in high concentrations of crops sprayed with Roundup. Roundup promotes plant diseases like sudden death syndrome in soy, process wilt in corn. The organism is in high concentrations of those diseased plants. When they isolated the organism and exposed it to a pregnant chicken, it killed the embryo in 24 hours. And it is probably responsible, or is involved with, a near epidemic problem in the U.S. of livestock infertility. There was a dairy magazine that came out with an article on skyrocketing infertility among cows. They didn't know why. The Cattlemen Association in 2002 also described huge, huge problems with infertility in many, many herds. The fertility clinics in the United States, I think, are up 14-fold. Low birth weight babies are up in the United States. Reproductive interventions are up dramatically, all since GMOs have been introduced. So we see laboratory animals, livestock, and incidence of human disease. That's where we find the parallel. No human clinical trials on fertility with GMOs. Just an uncontrolled random experiment with the entire population of North America. Roundup is linked to birth defects. It is known to be linked to birth defects, and it's been discovered as early as the 80s, but the information was hidden. It also interferes with the production of aromatase, which is important for creation of estrogen. It also interferes with testosterone. It also creates fewer sperm and abnormal sperm in mice. So Roundup itself